In today's episode, I am going to show you how to add a video into a 3D set using Element 3D in After Effects. Let's begin. Our first step is to select a video. I'm going to select this one of a dog. However, first I need to remove the green screen. I will select the layer and then go to Effects. In Keying, I'm going to select Key Light, version 1.2. Inside the Key Light settings, I'm going to use the eyedropper tool and select the green screen. Once selected, Key Light will remove the green screen background. I'll take a look and see if I removed all the green. If not, I will have to adjust the settings. Well, everything looks good. It's time to export this video. Select the render queue window and drag your composition to it. Now make some changes to the output module settings. Select this here and make sure that our format is in QuickTime. Select the format options button, and under our video codec, we are going to select Apple ProRes 4444. Select OK. Now in video output, under channels, select RGB plus alpha. It is very important you select this. Otherwise, your video will export with a black background and not transparent. Now go and select OK. I will select a location to save the file. And I will also rename it to Video 01 Alpha. Select Save. And now I will render the video. Perfect. Now that it finished exporting, I will go and import it to my timeline. Go to File, then Import, and select File. Now, find the file we just exported and select it. You can see in my preview window that it shows a black background, but don't worry, it's transparent. Select Open. Now, click and drag the alpha video to our timeline. It exported with a transparent background. I will undo what I just did and delete the layer that has the green screen, and keep the new alpha version we created. Now I will create a new solid. Go to Layer, then New, and select Solid. I will name this E3D. And select OK. Perfect. Now add the Element 3D effect to your new layer. Go to Effects, then Video Copilot, and select Element 3D. What we are going to do now is make the alpha video be a texture layer. For that, we will have to select the Element 3D layer and then head over to its settings. We will select Custom Texture Maps, and under Layer 1, we will select our Video 1 Alpha layer. This looks good. Now go and hide our Video 1 Alpha video layer. And let's go into our Element 3D scene setup. Inside Element 3D, we will create a plane model. I will change this orientation to negative 90. And I will scale it a little. Okay. It's time to add our video to this plane model. head over and select the plane model arrow and select its texture. Under the diffuse section, select on the box that reads none set. And next to the load texture box, select the arrow. Here, we will select our alpha video. Now, for some reason, the alpha video seems to have some issues. Don't worry, as we can fix this. Select OK. The video looks a bit chaotic, and I can see that it seems semi-transparent. Let's fix that. First, let's stretch our dog plane. This looks good. Now let's remove these strange artifacts surrounding our dog. Let us scroll down to the advanced settings, and next to alpha threshold, I'm going to make that 0.03. Now this looks much better. We no longer see the artifacts. Let me rotate it, and oh wait, what happened? It disappeared. If this happens to you, don't panic. We can simply fix that by going to our advanced settings and under draw back faces, select the box. Perfect, that should fix that problem. Now that we have our video inside Element 3D, we can design and set to interact with our dog. I'm going to create a floor base to have our dog sit on. I'll go and create a cube and I will scale it to fit perfectly. This looks good. To keep organized, I am going to name my models. I will do that by selecting the model and do a right mouse click and select rename. I will name the dog plane dog. Now, I will drag the dog on top of the base I just created. This looks good. Let me scale the base a bit bigger. This looks good enough. Okay, since I'm going to be adding lights, I need to create the surface to receive the shadows. I will create another plane model and scale it to fit my scene. I'll drag it to touch the bottom of the base. That looks good. Now, I will rename it to Floor. It's time to add the matte shadow texture. Go to your preset tab in the physical folder, select and drag the matte shadow texture to the floor plane. Perfect, this looks good. Now go and select OK. Let us create a camera to move around our scene. Go to Layer, then New, and select Camera. I will leave it at 35mm and leave the name as is. Select OK. Now the shortcut key to use the camera controls is the letter C. When you press it more than once, you can shuffle through the three controls. I am mostly going to use the rotate and move tool. As you can see, our video of the dog is now inside Element 3D. Time to add shadows. For that, I will go and add a light source. Go to Layer, then New, and select Light. Make sure that your light type is parallel. Also, make sure that the cast shadow box is selected and select OK. Now I will position the light to point from the top down. I will change my view to 4 to have better control. I'll move this here. And move this up here. Okay, this looks good. However, we don't see the shadows. That's because we haven't activated them yet. Head over to the Element 3D settings, and then to Render settings. And Shadows, make sure the Enable box is selected. Give it a minute. And there you go. Now we can see the shadow of our dog along with the base. Now this is a simple example. However, I have my own 3D scene that I created and exported with Element 3D. Let me show you. I'll head over to Scene Setup in Element 3D. I am going to delete the base. And I am going to import my own 3D scene. Go to File, then Import, and select 3D Object. I'll head over to where I saved my 3D scene. And since I used Element 3D upon exporting, I was given these two files. One is a regular OBJ file, but the other one is a E3D file. The file we want to import is the E3D file, because the E3D file is the one that has the textures. If we import the OBJ file, we can see that it imports without the textures. And that is something that we don't want. So I'm going to delete it and import the E3D version. Again, go to File, then Import, and select 3D Object. Now let's import the E3D version and select Import 3D Object. Perfect. I will now check Normalize Size and scale it to fit my scene. This looks nice. Now here at the bottom, you can see the textures. I am going to remove the textures that I am not using in this scene by clicking on this arrow here and selecting Remove Unused Materials. Perfect. Now I am left with only the textures that I'm using in my scene. I like this. I will now select OK. And my scene will now update. This looks good. I'll press the letter C on my keyboard and rotate the camera to take a look. You can see how the shadows of the dog interact with the rocks behind it. I want to add a basic background. Go to Layer, then New, and select Solid. I will name this layer Background and select OK. I'll place it under the Element 3D layer. I want to add a gradient effect, so I will go to the Effects and Presets window and search for Gradient Ramp. I'll click and drag it to the background layer and play around with the colors. This looks good. Now I want to make the scene interesting by adding camera movement. I'll go to the camera settings and add keyframes to the points of interest and in position. Now I'll add keyframes to the end of the timeline. Perfect. Let me adjust the beginning a bit. Okay, this looks good. Finally, in the Element 3D settings, I am going to increase the map size for the shadow and increase the blur radius. Now, what that does is softens up the shadow. Let me get close so you can see what I mean. Look at the shadows. Okay, that's enough for the shadows. Now go to the Ambient Occlusion and select the Enable box. I will increase the intensity to 4. This looks good. I will go to the lighting controls and add a light source. I will select single light. This is good. Finally, I am going to soften up the edges of our dog. You can see how pixelated it looks. For that, I will go to the output section and under sampling and aliasing, I will make that 2. Now look what that does. It smoothens out the edges. And there you have it. You now know how to import a video in After Effects using Element 3D. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one.